good evening, everyone. Thank you all for joining us tonight on this pre-debate call. The call is on the record. We're honored to have Senator Marco Rubio with us here tonight to share his perspective on tonight's debate and take a few questions about the debate and about the clear choice that voters will face in the next 30 days. So with that, Senator.
Thanks for having me on. First of all, thank you guys for what you do to keep those of us who are believers in limited government and free enterprise and in liberty engaged, involved, and enthusiastic. And also thank you for what you do to hold us accountable. You know, a lot of people run as limited government conservatives, and then when they get elected, they don't necessarily live up to that. So I think that's a great service you do as well for the future of our country. As far as tonight is concerned, look, I think that one of the things that unfortunately has taken root in the mind of some in America somehow, and it's the thing the president tries to sell people, and that is that big government is good for the middle class. Big government is good for the people that are trying to make it. Nothing could be further from the truth. Big government is devastating for people that are trying to make it. You see, the very wealthy, the billionaires, and the large corporations, they may not like big government, but they can afford to deal with big government. And in fact, from time to time, you will see them use big government to their advantage. They'll hire the best lobbyists in Washington to get them some money or a special program or even an anti-competition law. But the people who can't afford to deal with big government is the small business entrepreneur. It's the people, it's the young couple trying to start a business out of the spare bedroom of their home. It's the people trying to start a new business after quitting their job and taking their life savings to do it. They're the ones that can't hire lobbyists to go to Washington and create loopholes in the tax code. They're the ones that can't afford to hire the best law firm in town to help them navigate the complexities of the regulations that they face. And so we've got to make and I think what you're going to see tonight is a very compelling argument as to how devastating big government is to the middle class. I think what I also hope we're going to hear tonight is how the ideas that President Obama is for have never worked, not just in America, but anywhere in the world. There's no country in the world that has ever built prosperity and a strong middle class doing the things that Barack Obama is asking America to continue to do. And so the last point I hope that comes across is it doesn't have to be this way. We really, the 21st century can be better than the 20th. That America can truly continue to be even better, more prosperous, more safer than it's ever been. But there's a handful of things that we're going to have to do to make that happen. And only Mitt Romney's offering those things. Tax reform that simplifies the tax code, makes the tax rate both predictable and affordable, and incentivizes investment in America. Regulations that are a product of the cost-benefit analysis. In essence, we're going to start asking how many jobs will this destroy? How many people will this put out of business before we put a regulation into effect? Repealing Obamacare and replacing it with market-based reforms that allow individuals to have more control over their health care dollars and more control over who their health insurer is. A pro-American energy policy that takes advantage of the fact that we're an energy-rich country and that the American innovator has allowed us to gain access to vast deposits of natural gas and oil that we've been blessed with. We just do a handful of things like that, and you will see this economy begin to grow much faster than 1.3%. You're going to see an unemployment rate that's going to be much lower than 8.1%. I think that's important because, as Joe Biden reminded us yesterday, over the last 4 years, the middle class has been buried in America. It's time to bring the middle class back. And the way you bring the middle class back are through policies that encourage people to go out there and start those businesses and create those new jobs that hire middle class workers and give raises to middle class workers because they're so confident in the future and because they're competition for their labor, that create new jobs and new careers for our graduates who are coming out of college. That's how you create prosperity. And that's the message we're going to try to drive home here tonight, and both during the debate and after.
Thank you, Senator. Operator, we're ready to take a few questions.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, if you would like to ask a question, please press the number one key on your phone. Again, to ask a question, press the number one key on your phone. Please wait a moment while questions come into queue. The first question is from Moe Lane with RedState.com. Please go ahead.
Yes, good evening. First off, thanks for doing the call, Senator.
Thank you.
I guess the question is, you probably have heard 6 billion pieces of advice for and against to do this, to that, regarding the debate tonight. What can you tell us, what is the Romney campaign taking away from that advice? What do you guys think you're going to be following?
Well, you know, I think the bottom line is this is an election. It's a very clear choice between two very different futures. If you want to know what the future will look like under Barack Obama, You need to look no further than the last 4 years. By the way, it's ironic that we're in Denver, where he made all these promises 4 years ago and standing in front of some Greek columns. You read some of those promises now, they're almost laughable, that he was going to go line by line through the budget and find wasteful spending. You know, that he wasn't going to raise taxes on the middle class, that he was going to help grow our economy. I mean, these are laughable things, especially, and you think of the budgets this president has offered in the 4 years that he's been there. He can't even get the Democrats to vote for these budgets. That's how bad they are. So this is a choice election between more of that, more of these failed policies that have never worked anywhere, not just in America, anywhere, and a future that reminds us that it's the free enterprise system that is the source of our prosperity, and that what we need to do is create incentive and opportunity for people to go out there and start those new businesses. You grow an economy two-way, it's very elementary. When people start new businesses and when people grow an existing business, and they're not going to do that if you're threatening them with higher taxes, more regulations, if energy is expensive, and if they're worried about the future. And so that's the choice that we have. And I think that increasingly America, I mean, and that it doesn't have to be this way, that we're not indefinitely doomed to live in this kind of mediocre economic situation, that we can do so much better, and we will do so much better if only we had a president that believed in the power of the free enterprise system.
The next question is from Michael Warren with Weekly Standard. Please go ahead.
Hi, thanks for doing the call, Senator.
Hi, Michael.
Hi. Mitt Romney seemed to have lost a lot of ground in some of these polls on some of the issues like the economy, on issues like taxes. What does he have to do tonight, and can he close that deficit? And does he have to address the criticisms of his tax plan, criticisms of his not being specific on his economic plan? What does he need to do to close that deficit?
Well, I think we need to be who we are, and that is the party of limited government and free enterprise, because I think most Americans really believe in it, and they understand it. What we have to do is we have to tie what we stand for to their lives. So imagine tonight if you're a middle-class American, you work, you have a job, you work 9 to 5 every single day, but you're struggling because you haven't had a raise in 5 years, and everything else is getting more expensive, and maybe your kids are getting ready to graduate from college, and they can't find a job either. So what are we going to do for them? And here's what we can do for them. What we're going to do for them is we're going to put government back into a role where government is going to incentivize people to take money out of the bank and put it into the economy, to start those new businesses, to invest in new businesses. Those create new jobs and more opportunity. We've got to get to that argument where we tie what we stand for to the hopes and dreams of real people and the struggles that they're facing. And we need to remind them that President Obama's had 4 years of experimenting with big government to try to turn this around, and it has failed. It has been a tremendous failure. And so those are the two things that we really want to talk about, and I think Mitt's going to do a great job tonight of pointing out what that choice is.
The next question is from KD Pavlich with townhall.com. Please go ahead.
Hi, Senator. Thank you so much for taking our call.
Hi.
I'm curious on how Mitt Romney is going to kind of avoid getting into the weeds with President Obama's class warfare rhetoric in terms of getting into the weeds on the details of the tax loopholes he's going to proclaim that he's supposed to be closing, and his accusations of essentially wanting to throw Grandma off the cliff. How are they going to stay away from getting into that demagoguery tonight in the debate?
Oh, I actually hope they'll get into that. Yeah, I hope it'll actually get turned to those topics, because I think those are weaknesses for President Obama. First of all, what's his plan to save Medicare? Where is it? Why is he? Isn't now a pretty good time to introduce it after 4 years of being president? He has no plan to save Medicare. His plan for Medicare is to use it to win this election by telling people things that aren't true. How about on taxes? He's proposing a middle-class tax increase. His budget proves it. Here's why. If we were to raise taxes on wealthiest Americans by 100%, let's say we took all their money, that still wouldn't be enough money to pay for all the promises he's made in his budget, not to mention $16 trillion in debt. So if taking all the money away from the wealthiest Americans is not nearly enough to pay for all his promises and for this debt, where's the money going to come from? It's going to come from the middle class. And so his own budget is an admission that he plans to raise taxes on all Americans, particularly middle class Americans. So I hope to get a chance to talk about that, because that is what the future is going to look like under Barack Obama.
The next question.
Operator, we have time for two more.
Okay, thank you. The next question is from John Brodigan with FTR Radio. Please go ahead.
Senator Rubio, thanks for doing this with us tonight. I had a question. What your take has been on, as far as like the voters go on the ground in Florida? I know there's been some criticism from us about some of the polling samples that have been coming out, but at the end of the day, none of them seem to have Mitt Romney in the lead. I mean, is that the feeling on the ground, and what does he need to do?
No, it's not. Actually, this is the way I would analyze polls in Florida. Number one, it's going to be a very close election. It's not I don't think it's out of the realm of the possible that the election could be as close as the 2000 election was. I mean, that's how close it is. But here's what we need to remember. Barack Obama won Florida in 2008. So the fact that this election is statistically tied means that there are people that supported Barack Obama in 2008 that are not voting for him this time. And that's a trend. That is a real trend that's developing in Florida and in other states that he won in 2008. And so I'm actually enthusiastic about it, because I think after tonight and after the next two debates, people will start to understand that this election is not a choice between two people, a Republican and a Democrat, Mitt Romney and Barack Obama. It's a choice between two very different futures. One future is a future where the government is increasingly more involved in our economic lives, a strategy that hasn't worked anywhere in the world, a strategy that people come here to get away from. And the second strategy, which is the one that made us prosperous and built our middle class, and that is a vibrant private market where new businesses are created, where people are constantly being hired, where people are getting raises because they do a good job, and because if they don't get a raise, someone else will hire them away. That's the future that we want. That's the future that we're offering.
Okay, and the last question is from Sarah Rumpf with Sunshine State. Sarah, please go ahead.
Hi, Senator. One thing that I'd like to ask, you've gotten to know Governor Romney a lot better on the trail as you've been traveling around during this campaign season. What's one thing that you'd really like to be able to convey to people that you've gotten to see, getting to know him better this year, that maybe people aren't seeing?
Things. Number one, he's a serious person who takes this issue seriously. I mean, to him, this is not about politics. This is not about winning a title to an office. This is about, he really is worried about the future of our country, and he truly believes that he can come in and make it better and make it better quickly. That's the first thing. The second thing is what an extraordinary person he is. I mean, this is a successful human being, not just a successful political figure. This is a guy who's a model father and husband and grandfather and community leader and member of his church, and just the kind of guy we all wish our kids would grow up to be. And I think the last point I would make about it is someone that's truly motivated to make America better. I mean, someone that really is driven into this race by a desire to see America do better than what it's doing now, because he believes in the free enterprise system. He has witnessed it with his own eyes. It's not someone who's read about it in a classroom somewhere. He has seen someone take an idea, find some investment, and turn that idea into a business. And that business has created jobs and prosperity for thousands and thousands of people. He has seen that happen over and over again in his business life. That's why he believes in free enterprise, and that's why he understands it, unlike this president, unlike so many people on the left. And I'm excited about having someone like that in the White House.
Great. Thank you so much, Senator.
Thank you, Senator. Well, that concludes our call for tonight. Senator, thank you so much for joining us and offering your perspective, and thanks to everyone on the other end of the line. And we're excited for the debate starting in exactly 2 hours.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks, Senator.